Today on The Hookup, we're going to learn how to connect an automatic pool controller to your smart home using a Node MCU. This box is called a pool controller, and it's basically the brain of my pool. You can buy all kinds of add-ons for these things to be able to control them remotely. When I had my pool installed, we paid for the RF remote to monitor the temperature, switch between the spa and pool modes, turn on the cleaner, and control the lights. 3 years after installing this $500 add-on, it stopped working, and I was forced to either pony up another $200 to $300 to replace the burned out transmitter board, or walk out to the control unit every time I wanted to heat up the spa or change a setting on the pool. Another option was to spend $400 to buy the board that lets me access my pool controller via the Pentair ScreenLogic app. But that's another app on my phone, and it still can't interface with the rest of my smart home. As is often the case, the final and best option here was for me to build a solution myself. For less than $20 in parts, I installed a Node MCU to interface with my pool via MQTT, and it's much easier to do than you might expect. Links are down in the description for all the parts you'll need for this project. On my pool controller, which is the Pentair EasyTouch 4, there's an option to connect a set of four buttons called a spa side remote. That spa side remote is supposed to be mounted somewhere near your spa so you can turn on the lights and toggle the modes between pool, spa, and cleaner. Don't be discouraged if you have a Jandy or a Hayward or some other brand of pool controller. Spa side remotes are available for almost every one of these, and they all have very similar electrical connections inside. I don't actually want a spa side remote. What I want is to emulate a spa side remote from my smart home devices. The connector for the spa side remote has four pins for the four buttons, one common ground, and an output for an LED. What we need to do is emulate button presses, and for this particular case, I'm going to use something called an opto-isolator. An opto-isolator is sort of like a switch. It's got an input leg and an output leg with a photoresistor in between. When the photoresistor is not exposed to light, the resistance is near infinite, which doesn't allow current to flow from the input to the output. But when the light is shined on the photoresistor, the resistance drops to near zero and the current can flow from the input to the output. So what supplies the light? An LED on the inside of the opto-isolator gets connected to the GPIO pin on your microcontroller and also to ground. When you use the digital write high command, it turns on the LED, reducing the photoresistor resistance to nearly zero, which then simulates the button press. The added benefit of an opto-isolator and the reason it got its name is that the two sides of the circuit are only connected via light, not wiring. So the chances of your microcontroller frying your device or vice versa is significantly reduced, which is a major plus when you consider we're hooking up an $8 Node MCU to a $600 pool controller. To simulate button presses on the spa side remote, I'll connect the four opto-isolators to four GPIO pins using 150 ohm resistors to limit the current that goes to that small LED in the opto-isolator. I'll connect the common ground to the emitters on each of the opto-isolators and the collector to each of the four buttons. Now I can write a little bit of code that simulates button presses when an MQTT message is received. Basically, the PubSub client library allows you to subscribe to specific MQTT topics, watches for commands, and then executes specific functions based on those commands. For this project, I'm going to subscribe to the MQTT topic commands/pool. When it gets the command spa, it'll press button 1 on the spa side remote. When it gets the command spa light, it will press button 2. When it gets the command pool light, it'll press button 3. And when it gets the command cleaner, it'll press button 4 to turn on each of those devices. I could stop this project right here and have a very functional little switch, but I've got a whole Node MCU in there. Why not use a few more of the pins? On the Pentair spa side remote, there's also an LED. This LED is off when the pool is in pool mode. It flashes when the spa is heating up, and it's solid on when the spa is fully heated. I can use this to figure out what mode the pool is currently in using the built-in Arduino pulseIn function. Basically, the pulseIn function is supposed to figure out how often a voltage source is turning on and off. If the pin goes from low to high before the time period is over, which I've set for 3 million milliseconds, which is 3 seconds, meaning the LED is blinking, that means the spa is heating. If the pin is in the high state, meaning the LED is on, that means the spa is on. And if there's no pulse and the pin is low, that means that the LED is off and that the pool is in pool mode. Because we know the current state of the pool, we can also make our spa pool button a little bit smarter. If I send the command to turn the pool on, but the pool is already on, it shouldn't actually press that button. And the same goes for pressing spa while the spa is already on. The last feature I wanted to have was the temperature sensor on my pool. My pool controller has a temperature sensor built into it, but decoding the serial data sent from the pool controller would be a real headache. So I'm just going to piggyback off the built-in temperature sensor and calculate my own temperatures. The thermometer on my pool is a thermistor, which means that it's a variable resistor that resists a different amount based on the current temperature. To read the thermistor using the NodeMCU, we just need to connect the analog pin on the NodeMCU to the negative side of the thermistor, and then write a little bit of code to sort out the temperature. I had to modify this code quite a bit because it was written for a 5-volt source and a 5-volt analog pin, but we're using a 5-volt source and a 3.3-volt analog pin. You can just copy the code that I've written here. Now we need to install it in the pool controller. I'm using a buck converter to step down the 15-volt DC current to 5 volts so I can use the VIN pin on the NodeMCU. I've also hooked up this little breakout board to hook up the optoisolators and make it easier to manage. One last thing that you may or may not need to do based on your own Wi-Fi situation is extend the range of your NodeMCU. I made my pool controller before I had Google Wi-Fi and before the Wemos D1 Mini Pro with its external Wi-Fi antenna connection had been released. In order to add an external antenna, I scraped away the base of the antenna trace and soldered on a jumper wire. I read online that this would never work because the length of the antenna is specific to the frequency of Wi-Fi. But I did it anyways, and it actually worked perfectly. If I was making another one of these, I'd probably just use the D1 Mini Pro and avoid this extra headache. But it's nice to know it's an option if need be. Now that our device is hooked up, we can add it to Home Assistant. I've got MQTT sensors set up for pool status and temperature, and MQTT switches for pool mode, pool light, spa light, and pool cleaner. I'll add these to my configuration.yaml file using the correct MQTT topics and restart Home Assistant. Once they're added, my pool is now fully integrated into my smart home for under $20. Here are some of my favorite Node-RED automations for the pool. This one is a simple schedule for the pool cleaner, but it disables itself whenever we have company in town. And this one sends a message of pool cleaner malfunctioning to my phone if the temperature of the pool measured at the pump is greater than 95 degrees and the spa mode is not active. This typically happens if somebody knocks the pool cleaner hose out by accident, and it allows me to easily shut off my pool cleaner, preventing any damage to my pool pump. Today we made a pool controller. But this general concept of emulating key presses can be used to add almost any dumb device into your smart home. If you've got a question about a dumb device you'd love to add to your Home Assistant, post it down in the comments and I'll see if I can give you a good place to start. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. And as always, thanks for watching The Hookup.